Hey guys, it's your broker Bears, and welcome to my FIFA 16 Liverpool promo where last time I left off. I started a new season, and you saw the debut Cristiano Ronaldo, but I'm not here to talk about anything about career mode. I want to talk about the week that Liverpool had. Disappointing result in the Europa League, that's not what this is about. Justice was finally done. Those poor victims of the Hillsborough disaster were finally he cleared of any blame for the disaster. The fact that it took 27 years is a freaking joke. It should have been done in 27 seconds. The fact that those poor people who just went to a game of football, who just wanted to see their team play the game that they loved. If they went to that game and they didn't come back. And for 27 years, we've been saddled with the blame. They've been saddled with the blame. And finally, they got the justice they deserve. And now, we wait to see the punishment. Those assholes who put the blame on the wrong party. And the rightful people to blame will get that. And once that is done, everything will be as it should be. And you're probably asking yourself, Corey, why didn't you make a video earlier in the week? On the day of the announcement, I was in tears. Like most Liverpool fans, I was so emotional. It was just not gonna happen.
For his ability, that the manager still picks him, even though he wants away.
Thankfully, the blame has been lifted. And to any football fans, like Manchester United, it's idiot fans. And when we play him in Europa League, he's singing about the Hillsborough disaster. I hope you can look yourself in the mirror. Go home. Go to your nearest mirror. But look yourself in the mirror and say, what if those 96 people, what if one of them had been a member of my family, had been a brother, had been a mother, had been a father, had been a son, had been a daughter, had been any kind of relationship. Look yourself in the mirror and know you are a heartless bastard if we could kill you and bring them back, we would. Because it would be justice. Because if you don't care about life, then you don't deserve life. If it's a disgrace, and let it end. I've heard some people are still making horrible comments about the Hillsborough tragedy. Do us all a favor and fuck Roy off, because your opinion no longer is valid. Because it's wrong, we always knew it was wrong, and now, if you still think you're very funny, you're disrespecting 96 innocent people for something, and they have been deemed innocent. Of it was not their fault. If you still want to make jokes, then you should just don't deserve to live. If you don't deserve to support whatever team you support, because it's anyone who would think that just because that what happened was a great big laugh, it's a great big laugh. No, it's not a great big laugh. It's a serious business. It's a serious thing. you would not like it if something like this happened to your fans. If something like this happened to your team. If this has happened to any of our team in
Bradley Johnson.
In the jokes would still not be funny. It doesn't matter if it was Liverpool. It's not funny. And if you're still making jokes, then I'm afraid you just don't deserve life. You're a waste of human. You're a waste of the very air that those 96 people should be breathing right now. And it's a disgrace that over 27 years, there are people who still want to make jokes, still think that they're great, fantastically funny, still think they're a great big fucking laugh. No, you're not.
28 minutes played, 1-0.
Interesting news again.
It's not funny. It's never been funny. Let it end. And if you still want to make jokes, just like I said, look yourself in the mirror and just think, what if one of those people had been my family? If you still find it funny, then you have no heart, and you have no soul, and you don't deserve to watch this beautiful game that those poor people just wanted to watch. They just wanted to enjoy a game of football, and they were wrongfully charged with something for 27 years, and you're still making jokes. It's a disgrace.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. To score! Corner.
I've nothing more to say to the people like that. Let's focus on the game. And as Norwich's keeper is proving that tough guy score pass.
Shots on here. A goal.
Oh, there we go. That's how you. When you're struggling, you just bang him. And there it is, to the man. Fantastic shot. It's an absolute thunder shot. Boom. Not quite the top corner. Too high to be the bottom corner. Middle of the corner?
Great news for Liverpool.
I don't think that's a thing. Anyway, it's 43 minutes going, and it's 1-0.
And the decision for the added time is 3 minutes. Bale. Oh, he's through.
Ronaldo, 2-0.
Goal. A goal from Cristiano Ronaldo. What a finish this was.
Two goals. This is too easy.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. And the referee is blown for half time. It's 2-0 here.
There's a half time whistle. Very little goals in the other Premier League games. One in the Arsenal-Man City game. Two in Middlesbrough versus West Brom. Man United are winning 1-0 against Sheffield Wednesday, who are also assholes for not making sure their stadium was up to standards. And Chelsea are beating Southampton 1-0. There's no goals in the game between Hull and Watford, and Everton and Spurs haven't kicked off.
Referee blows, and we're off for the second half. Jakob.
I don't know. He's playing the advantage to
Cristiano Ronaldo.
To him. Neymar.
Oh, the strikers stopped there as they broke away. Good defending.
Rosello. Now the shot.
That's well wide.
Andre, who's apparently booked. He was probably the player who was booked when the wall moved earlier for the Marco Royce free kick in the first half.
And coming up for you on EA's.
Because I know we saw him make a challenge, and I don't think he's
Manchester City away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
If he was just about to make a very stupid decision, because if he found me again, he might have been off. Although, I'm pretty sure he wasn't booked. Hey!
Maybe once in training, he's put it in the top corner.
Yeah, that was just.
I hit first time to try and take advantage that the keeper was in. Goal and. Oh well. Nathaniel, I thought you'd tackle the ball. Will not just fall down.
Marco Royce.
Royce.
Neymar. That's a good challenge between the two of them.
Neymar, no, he wasn't. Son wasn't. Right
into the middle.
Neymar. Looking for Ronaldo. It's come to Coutinho. Did Malungo get blocked on that, or is it a goal kick? No, it did. It hit him in the corner. Somehow I missed Cristiano Ronaldo, and Neymar can't keep it.
It's gone out for a throw on the other side of the field. Norwich City's next game, Alan.
Yeah, they're playing Hull City, aren't they, in the next match in the Barclays Premier League, and it's got the look of an extremely tight game.
Nathan Redmond.
Timmans, good block. Ooh. Get rid of Laporte. Cute.
Like that, get back on the ball when they're defending so much. No way.
Offside, get back.
Forget about that one.
Stretching the Neymar, is he? I was just gonna say, he's not. He can't defend. I knew from the space he had that he wasn't on. So I was like, can't.
I think they've caught him offside there.
And of course he wasn't. Coutinho. Well, so hard to square your name on. And apparently I fouled the North player there. Or might have been offside.
Basson.
Basson? What's he doing up there? Her. Have they got. Oh my god. The computer is still making this stupid error. They're going on a low attack.
Neymar. And here comes the counter-attack.
That's going to be three. Oh, here is it. Oh, good save from the keeper. But that's why they shouldn't have gone all that. Yeah, that's what happened.
And I thought he was going to score.
And shoots!
Oh, Neymar bends it. 3-0. Wraps up the points. I was hoping he'd do the turn around and point to his back celebration. I guess running at the camera means almost punching the cameraman in the balls will do. It's an interesting just a celebration, Neymar.
One team really on
yeah,
game
3-0.
Today.
That wraps up the points. Where'd that my three goals looking at the end of the half? Like, two men scored in the 43rd minute. Ronaldo scored in the 45th. Neymar in the 90th. Arsenal beat Manchester City. Yeah, I knew that's what I would do. That is fantastic. And I have the chance to damage City's title hopes, early title hopes, more, because they're my next game. There's a bit of a gap between now and then. So let's see that. There goes Hanging Niles. There we go. There's a team that will actually play him. Leeds. That's all I'm looking for. That's all I want when I'm looking for a wild player. He has to go to a team that will give him the first thing I'm hoping for. So anyway, let's go to the Etihad and play Manchester City.
He does keep horses, and he is himself a footballing thoroughbred. Thomas Muller.
Muller and Neymar both different form players. Muller for them, Neymar for me. I was actually considering whether I should bring Muller. He's one of the choices I was looking at when I was a favorite to replace Correa with. Overall, I decided I'd go for a really high rate option. Plus, I used Muller in last week.
But just one lone striker.
After two seasons, really enjoyed him. I'm definitely going to use him again at some point in the future. But I decided I'm not really used Ronaldo that much, so why not?
Momentarily, but it is a corner.
But yeah, Muller could have those goals in Liverpool, sure. But as they go with Cristiano Ronaldo, how did Nathaniel Clyne miss? With Joe Hart off the line, all you have to do, a few inches, it's in the back of the net.
Touré.
Would have been a hell of a goal for the right back. Whoops.
The score!
Coutinho, brilliant goal. Cool. Well, just like in real life, Coutinho was banging them in against Manchester City. The commentators point this out as well. He seems to still love playing into Manchester City for some reason.
Liverpool have the lead here.
I guess every player has that one team. Like, Luis Suarez played for Liverpool. Well, I'm sure Norwich fans don't need reminding how much he tortured them. I think it was something like 10 goals he got against them in like 4 games or something like that.
Trying to get it wide.
He scored some
supporting player, Nathaniel Clark.
Crazy long range towards the end zone goal. Causes their raw extra salt in the wounds. Penalty. Don't you start now. Oh, hope English referees I had this problem. Although I'm in my Braga career mode. But yesterday, either the referees were not giving me penalties. Actually, I had 2 in yesterday's episode, but they weren't given.
Very good. Intercepting play there to get his positional situation right and win the ball without too much effort.
Hopefully the English referees aren't starting in the same pattern.
It's with Touré. Here's Sterling. Space for the shot! Muller! Well, he could have put that away, but not quite.
And that kind of proves why not signing Muller was a good idea, because he just missed a real opportunity.
Fire right at him, but he's kept the ball well.
Hey there, to equal at Manchester City. Neymar.
Past his man here. This is how they love to play on the break.
He's going
to
outpace David Luiz every day. To the man.
He just reached it, the goalkeeper.
He was pulling me back. I wanted to start ages ago. Royce. Boom. Near post 2-0. And Joe Hart is not a happy one. Royce takes the ball, Sabaleta. And takes his time and then bangs it in the net.
Restarting at 2-0.
Joe Hart is not having a good day.
Liverpool will get the throw. Rafael Varane. He spotted a teammate and he's got the technique as well as the vision to switch the play. It's good work with the ball.
Oh, he's like... Navas behind and I couldn't convert. Neymar.
Manchester City are the side trailing here despite having more possession.
I'm sure Joe Hart is just hoping for half time, but it's not going to come soon enough because it's 3-0 and it's Philip Coutinho again.
I think
he scored a few goals last season. He had his best scoring season the season before that. Is he going to have another great took a deflection off Clichy, maybe he's some other Manchester City player as well, but it's still Philip Coutinho's goal. It's still 3-0. Well, it would have been 3, you know, even if it was an old goal, but it's never going to be given. If anything, Clichy helped to him. It's not like he put it in himself.
Trying to find Muller. Good hands, bread and butter.
And Muller's chance is gonna be a haunting miss now. He could have made it 1-1. Instead, it's gonna be a half time, 3-0. There is the half time whistle. Referee's seeing enough of him. Me torturing Joe Hart for 1.5. Here we go with the second half. We get the torture again, boys. Not pop with Joe Hart yet. Oh, and there it is. There it is. It's 4-0.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Manchester City. Who won their first game 5-0. Are now 4-0 down. And then are staring a second straight defeat against, would have to be considered two title rivals, because Arsenal finished second last year. And I'd be in no way surprised if they were up there again.
The other very off colour. Well, this is a real shock. You can see it in the faces of the players, and you can hear it in the lack of noise, if you like, from these supporters.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to give their players any stick at the moment. They're just stunned into silence.
Though he's fairly important to the ref. Need to get Ronaldo off the ball, but they can't stop 5-0. They won't have me 5-0. He didn't get his goal earlier, but he's got it now. And Joe Hart is just having a bad day. 3 goals in the first half, 2 in the second half.
Tightest game we've seen, Alan, but it's extraordinary. It's gone the other way.
Yeah, it has. It has. I think everybody in the stadium is quite surprised by that, because the one side has been knocking the ball about nice and crisply, the other one's been chasing it and looked flat, lethargic.
Toure. Gael Clichy. And he's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
Tim out. Neymar somehow won it there from Neves. Oh, Coutinho was... He was looking. He was on the prowl for goal number 3. Wow, seriously, they're giving it straight back to me. Royce. He's already scored against. Let's see. Okay. Dancing in. Can't make it 3. Oh, Coutinho. Just over the bar. I think it's... Oh, no, it didn't hit company. It looked like it did. Wait. Must have just missed him.
Pablo Zabaleta.
I thought he might have made 3 goals in the game for himself.
That is a terrific.
And Muller misses on their chance. Not as significant as Zuri miss, when he could have made it 1-1. And I'm compelled to remind him again that he could have made it 1-1 at some point. That must seem so long ago.
Jotto! Block from David Luiz.
And it's a corner.
That bit lucky, it was deflected.
Off David Luiz.
Tries to punch it away.
To the man. Philippe Coutinho! Oh! I can't tell who it was, but someone did enough to got enough of his body in the way to prevent Coutinho getting the show away. But Bale makes it 6, so it's okay. It's all good. The demolition does continue. It's Mr. Calif Bale. Cool. It's first goal of the season. Going to fill the third match, but it's good that you are. Scoring to Carlos, Mr. Bale.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
And Manchester City must be feeling like everything is going against them, because Ronaldo has scored again. It's 7-0. CR7 makes it 7.
The goal from Cristiano Ronaldo, and he'll have enjoyed that. Don't think he scored many better. The composure to place it to the left.
And here is another angle on that goal. Totally one-sided, really, the match, as the scoreline suggests.
That's 2 goals for now, and so we have 2 players on hat-tricks now. Cristiano Ronaldo looking for his first hat-trick back. He might get it, and he has. CR7 is hitting the match ball. Home. I bet Coutinho is hugging him and saying, "You bastard." Because they both speak Portuguese. He's so they'd be able to communicate. Ain't no problem.
Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it? There's only really one team in it, only one team enjoying this.
Now what really seems to like doing is a tip-grabbing celebration, doesn't he?
Nasri. Throw-in coming up.
It's a bit weird that apparently he's scoring a hat-trick makes him really horny, apparently. To each his own, I guess. And for poor Joe Hart, he's wishing he could go back to the first time. It was only 3 and a half time. It's going to end 8. No.
Rafael Varane. Yaya Touré. There we go, final whistle.
I was going to say, when is the referee going to give me my but he blew the final whistle instead. He's ended Manchester City's misery. More importantly for one Joe Hart, he's ended Joe Hart's misery.
Let's get a view on Cristiano Ronaldo's match here from Alan Smith. Well, he goes across and grabs the match.
And it has begun. The first of probably many he's going to get.
You can tell he knows the game.
Trying to think who I have next. I know in the next book, what I do have a match against Manchester United, but that'll be the second game. I'm trying to remember. Let's just look. It's Stoke. Stoke are probably looking at that like, oh, bollocks. So, in the next episode, I will have games against Stoke and against Manchester United when Cristiano Ronaldo makes his return to Old Trafford in a Liverpool jersey. Which, you know, fans are just gonna love, aren't they? There's not enough sarcasm in the world to specify that, is there? Great. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos very, very soon. Until next time, I owe you all. Have a great.